Welcome back to another episode of 4-Wheeling USA. In this episode, I'm going to answer some of the questions I've received about how to plan a trip to Namibia. In this episode, I will cover how I picked my destinations, how did I prepare the vehicle and caravan for the trip, how did I plan the route that I was going to drive, also what is allowed to bring into Namibia in terms of regulations and entry fees, and then I will also share some additional tips on things that I've picked up at the various locations during our trip. So enjoy the video with us. Selecting your destination or your location for a trip is probably the most important thing that you will do for a trip. But how do you get to it? How do you decide where to go? Well, surely you must have a bucket list. I've started up with a bucket list of places I wanted to see in Namibia. For example, I wanted to see the wild horses. I wanted to see Dead Fly. I wanted to see Sesrim Canyon. I wanted to see the Fish River Canyon. I wanted to see Ice. And that gives you a rough idea of where you want to go. But then also go out, watch videos. There's plenty of videos on YouTube, but I've watched a big number of them before starting the planning of the trip. And that gives you a good idea. It helps you to identify hidden spots that you don't know of. Even after I've planned the trip, I'm still watching videos, and to this day there's still places that I say, maybe we should have gone there as well, but you just have so much time. Another thing which helped me a lot is I put a rough plan together with the places I wanted to go to, and then I went to forums, and then I went to the Drive Nam Facebook page, 4x4 Community Forum, the 4x4 Action Group Forum, and asked them the questions there. What do you think about the trip? Is there something I must add, something maybe not worthwhile, things like that. And in this way, I was able to get in touch with some of the local people there. Gert Grobler from Namibia, thank you so much for your help and advice by refining the road. Because these people know the area, so they will tell you, listen, you can't drive there in one day. And I had some of those places where I said, we're just going to drive there in one day. And unfortunately, that's not how it works. So he gave me some great advice. For example, he put me in, he gave me the idea of the Beta campsite, which was one of the most amazing and nicest campsites we've had. And then, that's how you build. You fold it up and break up the road. But with your main framework, you've got sort of like a starting plan. And then from there, you refine it and put places in between. And that's in a nutshell how you plan or where you decide on where you want to go. By the way, this is a beautiful waterfall here behind me. I suppose when it rains, it's dry at the moment. But go have a look at the video for some more footage of this waterfall and how we came up this incline here. In terms of planning your route, I'm actually on a part of the route that we have driven. But how do you select it? How do you end up here? One of the tools is Google Maps. That's a good place to start, but it's not going to bring you here. This road is not even on Google Maps. So what do you do in terms of planning your route? Well, you've determined now what your destinations are. Then you do some reading up and get some experts involved. Actually, this part of the route I ended up thanks to Andre 4x4, the guy on Cakeney. I asked him, does he know about an interesting path we can drive or interesting road? And he suggested this piece of road, which ended up being a very beautiful part of the Namakwa Eco Trail. But to get here, I needed something better than Google Maps for this application. So for this, I used Tracks for Africa. Now, Tracks for Africa is a piece of software or a mapping software which gives you the map that you can have all of these unknown or smaller off-road driven parts of South Africa. They've got main roads on there as well, but the main purpose for that is to come to destinations like this. And with this tool, you can plan your route beautifully because it's got all the waypoints on there. For example, on this route, there's the Half Main Streets, and it's mapped on Tracks for Africa. So you find it and you select it and you drive there using Tracks for Africa. It's also a GPS system. It's not a a system that's like your cell phone or Google Maps that you need cell phone reception. What you can also do with Tracks for Africa's, they have this online tool now where you can plan your route and then you can export it and load it onto your GPS. Alternatively, you can still use the old Basecamp and then export your waypoints and put it on your GPS. It's just, there's so many tools available. But yeah, for me, the important thing was how to plan a route. And I've used Tracks for Africa for that. They do have paper maps as well. They've got this beautiful atlas as well. And I always carry that with me as well. So in case my GPS doesn't work, I still have a paper version to fall back onto. To keep in mind is how do you prepare your equipment, like your vehicle, your caravan, maybe yourself for a trip. You might come across an obstacle like this, like I've got here behind me. It's not very difficult, but if you've never driven it, how do you know how to approach it? Do you have the confidence to do it, or will you start being anxious to drive up there?
Upgrades that I made before the trip was to install new Maxxis all-terrain tires, a UDF second diesel filter, and also upgrading the 12-volt charging system on my Bush Lapa caravan.
In terms of regulations and entering Namibia, what's important to remember? When you enter Namibia, you will pay a border fee. It's about between 700 to 800 rand when we entered for a vehicle and a caravan. And then the next thing that's important, when you enter Namibia, you're not allowed to bring meat and vegetables in there. Easiest, don't go ask, but what about this, what about that, can it be that? Just don't bring it in and you'll be safe. They do check you at the border post. They checked us, opened the fridges, just don't bring it in. The same applies for dairy products and eggs. Don't bring it in, you can buy it just across the border. There's actually a very nice deli in Rosh Pinna where you can buy it. There's a Choppies, and at actually one of the stores, one of the hardware stores, you can actually buy very nice wood. You can also buy some of your products here at the Amanzi River Trail. So just to keep it easy, stay away from something that you're not sure about, and just buy it locally in Namibia, and by that you also help them out. In terms of extra tips, let's call them bonus tips, I think the first one for me will be not to believe everything that people tell you along the way. If you've done the previous steps right in terms of the planning of your trip and you know where going, you know what the roads are going to look like, back yourself. You know what you're going to do, you've got the experience, or you've done the training, you've got the equipment. For example, I had somebody that came up to me and asked me, where are we going to drive next? And we said, no, we're going to drive the D707. And I said, are you sure? I said, yes, with the camera. With the caravan. I said, yes, with the caravan. So he's been advised not to drive that road, and yeah, there's thick sand and people got stuck there. You know about a tour operator that had people that got stuck there. By the way, I contacted that tour operator. I'm still waiting for asking him to explain what happened there. Maybe there was a mistake or whatever. They drove next to the road. It hasn't come back to me yet, so I suppose he just didn't have the knowledge to help people through there. Because when we got there and when we drove the road, there was absolutely nothing wrong with it. Yes, there was a bit of sand, but deflating the tires to 1.5 bar didn't cause any problems. Same thing for this piece of road here. People said you will get stuck there, the sun's going to burn you, you cannot drive there alone with your family. And I did my homework. I did have a look at the road, I watched videos. I drove it from the other side actually as a dry run, and to make sure that I know that I can tow there with the caravan. On a dry run, or if you could call it a recce, I was able to do a lot of those parts in Namibia because I traveled there for work. So I was able to look at places before, and how does the campsite look, can I buy meat there, where do you buy wood. And by doing that, I was lucky to know that at least in Rosh Pinna there's a nice meat deli where you can buy all your meat. Amanzi River Trails, they've got meat that you can buy, your drinks obviously you can buy. So yeah, if you've done your homework properly, then there's nothing to fear, and then you know how to act against something that's not 100% right. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you found it useful, and I hope it will help you to plan your dream trip. I still have a lot of dream trips in Namibia. It was an amazing country for me to see. The places, some moments literally gave me tears in my eyes. So yeah, when we were at the wild horses and they came so close to us, when you walk there in death flay. So yeah, don't let anything stop you from achieving your dreams, achieving your goals, or going places where you want to go. If that's your dream, go do it. Thanks for watching. I will see you in the next episode.